scaricato da poco sul PC e ho scaricato anche i sottotitoli in italiano per tutti gli episodi. Ho preso la collection di tutti gli episodi. Vorrei riuscire a portarla tutta qua su YouTube, però non lo so. Spero di farcela, portarla sempre tutta. Spero che vi piaccia questo gioco. Iniziamo. Subito a giocare. È un gioco dove devi fare delle scelte e le scelte che fai condizionano tutta la tua storia su The Walking Dead. Chi salvi, chi non salvi, chi muore, chi non muore, dipende tutto dalle tue scelte, da come va avanti tutta la storia. Dipendono le tue scelte, le cose che dici ai personaggi. Vediamo se riusciamo a registrare questo video perché è l'ennesima volta che lo registro.
Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
Why do you say that?
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it.
And what do you say?
I say, yep, I know you didn't. Followed your case a little bit, you being a making boy and all.
You're from Macon, then?
Yep. Came up to Atlanta to be a city cop in the 70s. Always wanted to work a murder case, like that senatorial mess you got yourself mixed up in. With all due respect. A real shame, that is. Hell, the whole family used to be regulars at your folks' drugstore right in downtown. Still there?
Sure is.
Good. I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on a 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
Not really.
Too bad. My car. You might have the right to remain silent, but it don't mean I gotta be. Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman. I'm driving this man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses.
He's just waiting.
Says it wasn't him. crying and snotting all over right where you sit. Then before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. Now tell him he's got to stop. That's government property, and I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
So did he do it?
They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over. I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious, if I do say so. This
Watch
other
out.
Time...
myself out that window. Holy shit! Get away from me!
Ah!
anybody. Coming in. Don't shoot, okay? Ah! Hello? I'm not an intruder. I'm one of them.
This place has been ransacked. Just about anything worthwhile is gone. Marshals. That's a Savannah area code. But that's the type of note you'd leave a babysitter. Furniture over time, blood everywhere. Jesus. Maybe there's something out there.
Stop beeping. Message 1, left at 5:43 p.m.
Hey, Sandra. This is Diana. We're still in Savannah. Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day. Thanks so much for looking after Clementine, and I promise we'll be back in time before your spring break. Oh my God, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
Message 3, left at 6:51 a.m.
Clementine, baby. If you can hear this, call the police. That's 911. We love you. We love you. We love you.
They tried to get me, but I'm hiding until my parents come home.
Why? What's your name?
I'm Clementine. This is my house.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee. How old are you?
8.
And you're all alone?
Yes. I don't know where anybody is. How old are you?
I'm, 37.
Okay.
Where are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think, where the boats are.
Where are you?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
That's smart.
See? Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
Did you kill it?
I don't know. I think so.
Sometimes they come back.
Have you killed one?
No, but they get shot a lot.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look. I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
We need to get out of this neighborhood. It's not safe. We're less likely to be seen if we move at night.
My parents might come home.
We won't go far. We'll try to find shelter and come back here with others.
That sounds good. We can hide in my treehouse until then.
It'll be a tough climb with this leg, but that's a good idea. Let's go. Stay close to me. Now, let's stay quiet. We'll head out to the front yard and follow the road out of the neighborhood.
Okay.
It'll be okay. Stay near me, and we'll move as fast as we can.
Resta dietro di me, però. Più avanti di me. Sono zoppa.
Are we going to die?
No, I'll die. Non dire così.
No, I'm sure we're fine.
Stay down! Georgia State Patrol!
Dude, he won't listen to that.
Okay! Oh shit, you're not one of those things.
Neither of us are.
Oh, damn, you've got a little girl. We're sorry about that. Well, Andre's sorry about that.
It's Officer Mitchell.
My name's Sean. Sean Green. This is Andre.
Officer Mitchell.
Did you see any of those things? One of them just got our buddy Chet.
No, not for a while.
Looks like you cut the shit out of yourself.
My leg, yeah. It's hurt pretty bad.
Look, help us find the thing that got our buddy, and we'll take you and your daughter down to my dad's farm to save you. You should be able to fix your leg up, too.
I'm not her dad. I'm just some guy.
Some guy?
Yeah.
She's alone?
Whoever you are, let's get a move on.
We just were...
Oh, shit. It's Chet.
Let's go. Get to my car. Go!
Non so se faccio bene a dire la verità.
Say hi to your dad for me.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Sean. Chet was a good dude.
One of the best.
Take care of you two.
Thank God you're okay.
I was worried it'd be bad here, too.
Been quiet as usual the past couple days. Well, Brecken down the way thinks his mare's gone lame, but that ain't nothing new.
I ran into Andre outside of Atlanta, and, Chet, he got killed.
No, you're kidding.
Those things got him. Dad, I don't know what's going on.
I'm sorry, Sean. You brought a couple guests.
Your boy's a lifesaver.
Glad he could be a help to somebody. So it's just you and your daughter, then?
Oh, not his daughter. He's, well... just some guy who found her alone.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yes.
Okay, then. Well, looks like you hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Yeah, it's not doing so good.
I can help you out. Sean, run on in and check on your sister. You, take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is swollen to hell.
It hurts like hell.
I bet it does. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green. How'd this happen?
Car accident.
That's so. Where were you headed before the car accident?
I was getting out of Atlanta.
The news says stay.
Yeah, well, that's a mistake. We hit a guy. One of those things you've been hearing about. On the road.
Who were you with, the girl?
I was with a police officer. He was giving me a ride.
Awful nice of him.
I'm an awful nice guy.
House is full up with mine. We got another displaced family of three sleeping in the barn. You and your daughter are welcome to rest there, and we're done here. I didn't catch your name, darling.
Clementine.
Can't imagine what you've been through, Clementine.
Looking after her until we find her parents.
Hey, Dad. So I'm thinking, first thing tomorrow, we gotta reinforce the fence around the farm.
And what happened to your friend? Maybe that's not a bad idea.
It smells like...
manure.
Manure? Like when a horse plops?
Just like that.
I missed my mom and dad.
I bet, Clem.
How far is Savannah?
Pretty far.
Oh, okay.
Hey, get up.
I'm itchy.
Well, you slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm, not a dad. Name's Lee.
I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of a fence. There's a tractor and everything.
We better get going, or we won't hear the end of it. That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Duck, though.
Duck?
Yeah, nothing bothers him. Like water off a duck's back, you know?
That's a valuable treat lately.
No kidding. But frankly, I think it's because he's dumb as a bag of hammers.
Dad!
But he makes up for it with enthusiasm. The word is, you were on your way to Macon.
My family's from there.
Well, Macon's on the way, and personally, I'd appreciate the company of a guy who can knock a couple of heads together if he has to.
I'll see what the girl
wants. Ah, gotta consult the missus. I understand. Honey, Duck, this is Lee. And, what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
I want to build a fence!
Yeah? Well, I need a good foreman. You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On the tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to it.
I can keep an eye on your little girl here on the porch. We can visit.
It gets lots of tingles.